and welcome to Kemper Bushcraft. Today it's a little bit windy. I don't know if you can hear that.
I made a new setup for my GoPro.
Aluminium case with an external microphone attached to it. And on the microphone there's something that should reduce the wind noise. I don't know if it's working because it's the first time I'm trying it out, so I hope that it will be okay. I'm in the Little Wild Bog and I'm going down to the shelters. I've been there many times before, and the reason for that I'll tell you a little bit later. But the weather is not so good today. I hope for a little bit sun, but they promise rain later.
Yeah, and here we are. So,
and because of the wind, I have to find the best of these shelters. You can see, well, this one is the one I have used many times, but the wind is coming from that direction, so perhaps there's not enough cover here, and I'll take this one. Yeah, I think I'll do that. You can see in here there's plenty of protection from the winds. Very nice. So now I have to rig my gear and tell you a little bit why I'm out here today. So hang on. Well, this wood is not completely dry. I found a few pieces. I have to search a little bit more. It doesn't protect it from all the moist and rain that's coming. So now I'll search a little bit more and find some pieces that are dry. Yeah, it's sharp now. Let's chop some wood. Well, as I said before, I'm definitely no master in making feather sticks, and again, I don't use it very often, so perhaps it's something I have to
to practice in. Well, I hope this will do. Or else I have a backup plan.
Well, my plan was to go out in the forest in Rold Forest and make a little delicious lunch. But because I only have to, I only allowed to make bonfire certain places, I have to choose a place that has some kind of shelter if it's beginning to rain. And out in Rold Forest, there's no good places for that, so I decided to go here to the little wild bog. I know there's a fireplace here and dry firewood and some nice shelters that can protect me if it's going to rain. So I have made a little thing. I will show you how I will prepare for the fire. But first of all, I'm going to make my fire, and I'm going to use the coals, so it has to burn a little bit down before I use it. So yeah, I hope you like it. Hang on. Well, this is three piles of wood. I made something small with feather sticks on, and some small sticks, a little bit larger than pencils. I hope it works. And some larger one that I can feed the fire when it is going well. First of all, I'll make a foundation for the fire so that the wet and damp ground doesn't make any problems. I'll see if I can get a spark into this feather sticks. No, it didn't work. I'm a little bit rusty in that, so I'm going to make it with some birch bark. Let's see. Very windy today, and it causes a little bit problem. Well, every time I scrape this birch bark, the wind comes and blows it away. So, I think I'll go with a cotton ball. Oh, we have a fire. Yeah, now I put this bricks on so it shades a little bit from the wind. And
helps a little bit. And actually I can use these for my lunch when I'm preparing that. So that's okay.
Now that I'm sure that the fire will be kept alive, I'm going over to the shelter and prepare my my little dish, my food. First I'll find my Opinel knife that I have in here, and here it is, so I can cut the food. And then I'm going to take this little cutting board, and in here I have my food. I have some meat in this little plastic bag, some red bell pepper, some tomatoes, just put them there. Yeah, oops, stay here. And some mushrooms, champignons. Yeah, and I'll start with by cutting these bell pepper out. I think I'll take this one. Four. Oops. I think I'll make six of them. Four, five, and six. And this one I can eat. And in here, in this little bag, I have some pork meat that I fried a little bit yesterday, so it is not completely raw, and I think that's the best thing when I'm going to do what I'm going to do now. So stay here. No, I'll just cut these up in small, in halves. Yeah. Oops. And then I have these grill sticks. And I'll start with red pepper. And then a little bit of meat. Yeah, and half a mushroom and a little sausage, red pepper again. Oops. Okay, I have to be careful with the mushrooms. So well, you get the picture. I make two of these. As you can see, I made three grill sticks or spear, and now this little, well, I don't know what you call it, but I can put this over the fire and I grill my grill spears. And so, it's actually beginning to rain. So, yeah. But I think it's hot enough, so I can place this over it. I'll just move this brick a little bit further away, if I can that without burning myself. Oh, smoke gets in my eyes. Yeah. And the reason why I have cooked them, the pork meat from home, is because if it doesn't have enough warm, if it's not hot enough, this meat will be, well, not raw, but it not be cooked enough. just make it a little bit wider. Maybe I lower the bricks a little bit. I think that would be a good idea. Just take this off and lay this down. And this one down too. And make this for a little windscreen. And I'll see, yeah, that's much better. And I even got it smoked, so it's like a fine restaurant. Smoked pork. Now we just have to wait. Just turn them. Yeah. I can see they are beginning to take color from the fire. So I think this would be a very nice meal indeed. Oops. Then suddenly it's getting really hot. A lot of heat, that's good. Yeah, let's check them out. I think it's done. Look at that meat. It's well, yeah. So now I'm going to take the grill and take it over where I can eat it. And in the meantime, I'll put some water over for my coffee. Look at this, isn't it great? The only thing we have to do now is put some salt and pepper on it. Oops. Yeah. I think I'll do it this way. Yeah, and a little bit of pepper. Then I can eat. And I'll just take this up in my mouth and eat them. Alright, it is so good, and it has this smoke taste. It's really nice. And the meat is well done. So,
As you can see, the fire has arisen again, as I expected, so that my water can be boiled warm enough for my coffee. And one of the advantages with this setup is I can lift this so that the water, when it's beginning to boil, doesn't boil the coffee too much, but just right. Let it simmer, I think it's called. Yeah, now it's beginning to boil. Then I'll just have to raise it a little bit. Yeah. Yeah. Perfect. Perfect. I can put this. As you can see, the coffee is only boiling a little bit. Just enough to keep it right. And you have to boil about a minute. Well, that's the way I do it. And then I can take it. Now it's finished. And I can bring it with me. Yep. Over to the shelter. And I can put it here and come a little bit of cold water in it before I drink it. Then I have my cookser ready. Oh yeah. It's time for a pipe of tobacco. And I also have a shout out to one of my subscribers, a dear friend called Wade. He has a great channel called Woodswalkers 1965. And of course I put a link below so you can go into his channel, and I really, really think you should check it out. He has some great stuff. He just posted three small videos with an overnighter, and they are so cool. And he doesn't have
much subscribers, and I can understand why, because his videos are so great. So go in, check him out, and I hope you like him, and perhaps you will like to subscribe to him. Many of you have probably noticed that I put up a video during the week that was a tribute to my old dog Cornelius, who died Monday. I was very sad, and actually I cried a lot Monday. I knew that one day it would be like that. He was an old dog, and you saw in my videos from Norway, he couldn't make the hills anymore, and he was almost completely blind and deaf, and he had trouble when he was out in the garden to find the door again and come in. But for a long time I thought he has a good life after all. His tail was wiggling, and he was very happy when he saw me come home from work. But during the weekend he got ill, he threw up, and there was a lot of things that were happening, and I could see that he was in pain, and I couldn't let him live on like that. So I decided to call the vet, and I got down to them Monday afternoon, and they put him to sleep. I was with him all the time, and afterwards I buried him in my garden and put a little stone with his collar on, so I'll always remember my old Cornelius. But then I made my video, and actually I cried a lot more after that, because all of you, and I won't call you subscribers because that's too technical, all your friends, my dear friends out there all over the world, you wrote so nice warm comments. Your compassion and your kindness, your comforting words, well, they got tears in my eyes, and I can't thank you enough. You are all so nice people, and I love you all. Now I have to move on, and I'm not sure that I will have another dog. Perhaps in some month I think different. I have had great pleasure in having Cornelius with me out on my bushcraft activities, and I know that a dog would be a nice thing for me to have. But on the other hand, when I'm going on vacation and so on, it's not all time I can have my dog with me, so I have to think about it. But again, thank you very much from the deep of my heart for all your kind comments and all your support. Yeah, I was stunned. Over 500 comments regarding my little dog, and all the, well, I don't know what to say. Today it's been a nice day. I made my meal and made my fire in another way than with my solo stove. It's nice to do that. It wasn't so good with my ferro rods, my feather sticks, and my birch bark. So I have to practice that a little bit more. I used my flint and steel for a long time, and I'm a little bit rusty in using the ferro rods. And actually, it was only to try to make fire in another way. So I'll practice that a little bit more, and I get back to where I was a couple of years ago. Now I'm going home to my wife Gitte, and we'll edit this video and bring it up on the YouTube, perhaps tonight, Saturday night, or Sunday. I hope you enjoyed it, And I thank you for watching Kimber Bushcraft. And I hope to see you again on my next video. Bye bye and take care.